Hello, this is Dr. R. Lakshmi, Faculty of Mathematics from St. Peter's Engineering College. Today I am here to explain you the most important topic from the graph theory known as isomorphism of graphs. Before I explain what the isomorphism of graphs, I would like to tell you the importance of the topic. In some areas of science and technology, we come across the questions like whether it is possible to determine, to draw the two graphs in the similar way, or whether it is possible that the two graphs have the same structure. To answer such questions, we can say that it is yes, if the graphs are isomorphic, they can possess the same structure and so can be drawn in the same way. Therefore, the learning of the concept isomorphism of graphs is essential for the purpose of determining that the graphs can have the same structure or not. Now coming to the concept, let us see first how the isomorphism of graphs is defined. The simple graphs G equal to V1 comma E1, where V1 is the vertex set of G, E1 the vertex set of G1. And the second graph G2 equal to V2 comma E2, where V2 is the vertex set of the graph G2 and E2 the edge set of the graph G2. Corresponding to these two simple graphs G1 and G2, we say that these are isomorphic if there exists a one-to-one and onto function between the two vertex sets V1 and V2 such that the vertices AB of the graph G1 are adjacent if and only if the vertices F of A and F of B in the graph G2 are adjacent. And this must be true for all pair of vertices AB of the vertex set V1. Let me explain this definition. Here we are defining isomorphism between two simple graphs. Simple graphs means those where there are no multiple edges between the pair of vertices. Similarly, the one-to-one function means the different elements of the domain mapping to different elements of the codomain. Onto function means becoming the range of the function equal to the codomain of the function. In other words, if there exists no element in the codomain which is left over without the preimage in the domain, the function is called an onto function. If between the vertex sets of the two given simple graphs, possibly a function which is one-to-one and onto can be defined possessing the property that whenever AB are adjacent in G1, their images F of A and F of B are also adjacent in the second graph, then we say that such a function is an isomorphism. If there exists no isomorphism between the graphs, we say that the graphs are non-isomorphic. Now let us consider the steps to determine whether the two given simple graphs are isomorphic or not. To prove easily this isomorphism of graphs, we must have to check the three invariants which are necessary if the graphs are isomorphic. One of them is the graphs should have the same number of vertices. Secondly, it is the graph should have equal number of edges. The third one being the graphs to have the same degree sequence. Whenever the graphs satisfy the three invariants, we can only say that there is a possibility for the graphs to be isomorphic. still there is no guarantee of isomorphism. Now to confirm that the graphs are isomorphic, we have to see that a function is defined between the vertex sets which preserves the adjacency of the vertices also. Suppose we want to prove that the graphs are not isomorphic, it is enough to check and say that any one of the three invariants do not satisfy. Whereas to prove that the graphs are isomorphic, along with the three invariants, we have to show that the adjacency of the vertices is also preserved by a bijection mapping between the vertex sets of the graphs. Let us consider few examples related to the topic. First example, let us see. Show that the graphs displayed below are not isomorphic. The problem is to prove that the given graphs are not isomorphic. So we confine here ourselves in checking of the three invariants, because we are going to prove that the graphs are not isomorphic. It is enough if we can say any of the three invariants is, any one of the three invariants fail. Let us see the first invariant. It can be clearly viewed from the two graphs that they have the same number of vertices, 5. Also, they have the same number of edges, 6. The first two invariants satisfied. Now, let us see the third invariant whether satisfied or not. When we see the first graph G, we have two vertices of degree 3, E and C, and the remaining vertices have each degree 2. Whereas when we look at the vertices of H, even though there are two vertices A dash and C dash of degree 3, the remaining vertices are not having degree 2. Only B dash and D dash are having degree 2, whereas E dash is having degree 1. So we have got a point here. In the graph H, there is only one vertex with degree 1. But there is no such degree 1 vertex in the graph G. So it is clear that the degree of vertices do not match in the two graphs. The third invariant failed, and hence we conclude our problem that the two given graphs are not isomorphic. Now coming to the second example, the problem is to determine whether the graphs are isomorphic. First we check whether the invariants are satisfied or not. We can clearly view from the two graphs that they have same number of vertices equal to 8, same number of edges equal to 10. Also the degree sequence is also equal, because in both the matrices G and H there are 4 vertices of degree 2, also 4 vertices of degree 3. This is the case with the two graphs. Therefore the degree sequence, the degree of vertices is also equal in the two graphs. So we say here that the three invariants are satisfied by the two graphs. Even then we cannot say now that the two graphs are isomorphic. To confirm isomorphism, there must be possibly a function to be defined which is bijection preserving the adjacency of vertices. To find out such mapping, let us consider the adjacency of the vertices in the first graph. We have in the graph G, degree of the vertex A is equal to 2. Because the degree of A equal to 2, this A must correspond to the vertices T, U, H, Y, because all of these have the degree 2 in the graph H. Only any one of these 4 can correspond to the vertex A of the graph G. But we can see that corresponding to each of the vertices T, X, Y and U in the graph H, one of the adjacent vertices have degree 2. But that is not the case with the adjacent vertices of the vertex A in the graph G. Therefore, we say that it is not possible to define a function between the vertex sets so that the adjacency is preserved. Hence, we conclude that the two given graphs are not isomorphic even though the three invariants are satisfied. Okay. Now, let us see the third example. The problem is to show that the graphs G and H are isomorphic. The graphs are shown in the diagrams. As usual, we check the three invariants first. Clearly, both of the graphs have equal number of four vertices and four edges. Also, the degree sequence is equal in the two graphs. There are four vertices of degree 2 in each of the two graphs. So, the three invariants are equal. Now, let us try to define a function between the vertex sets which preserves the adjacency of vertices in the graphs. Because U1, U2, U3 are adjacent, we can see that in the graph G, U1 is adjacent to U2, U3. Each have degree 2. When we see in the graph H, V1 is adjacent to V4 and V3 and each have the degree 3. So, with this observation, let us define the function as f of U1 equal to V1, f of U2 equal to V4 and f of U3 is equal to V3. So, one more vertex mapping remaining. So, we suppose f of U4 equal to V2. Now, with this defined function, let us verify whether it is 1-to-1 onto and preserve adjacency or not. Clearly, with the definition of f, we can say that the function is 1-to-1 and onto. So, it is a bijection. Now, to verify the adjacency of vertices, let us find the adjacent matrices of the two graphs. Let us first find out the adjacency matrix of G. We write the vertices of G along the row and also along the column. Along the first row, we write the elements as either zeros or ones based on the adjacent vertices of the vertex U1. Because in the graph G1, U1 is adjacent to only U2 and U3 in the matrix corresponding to U1, U2 place and U1, U3 place, we put ones. And in the remaining places, we put zero. Similarly, corresponding to the vertex U2, only U1, U4 are adjacent in the graph. Therefore, in the corresponding places, U2, U1, U2, U4, we place 1, remaining places are taken 0. According to this adjacency of the U3, U4 also, we fill in the matrix which is called adjacency matrix of G. Now, coming to adjacency matrix of H, according to the function defined, we take in the same order of the function as defined, the vertices along the row and column as V1, V4, V3, V2, both along row and column. Now, to fill in the matrix, because in the graph H, V1 is adjacent to V4 and V3, the corresponding places are taken 1 and the remaining entries of the first row taken 0. Because V4 is adjacent to V1 and V2 only, the corresponding places are taken 1, 1, and the remaining entries of the row zeros. Following the same rule, we fill in the other two rows also. So, we finally have got the adjacency matrix of H exactly equal to the adjacency matrix of G. It implies that the function whatever we have defined previously preserves the adjacency of vertices in the two graphs. Hence, now we are able to say that the two given graphs are isomorphic because along with the three invariants, when a function is defined between the two vertex sets, it is preserving the adjacency of vertices also. Now, as the last example, let us consider one more example. Determine whether the graphs are isomorphic or not. As usual, we first check whether the invariants are true or not. Clearly, when we look at the graphs G and H, both of them are having the same number of vertices and same number of edges. Also, it can be observed that in the two graphs G and H, there are two vertices of degree 3 and four vertices of degree 2. So that we can say the degree sequence is also equal in the two graphs. In addition to the three invariants, now we need to check whether a function defined preserves the adjacency of vertices or not. Because in the graph G, U1 and U3 are degree 2 vertices with their corresponding adjacent vertices having degree 3, and corresponding to the graph H, V2, V6 are the two vertices with a degree 2 on one side and degree 3 on the other side, V1, V4 having the same property, V4 and V6 with the property that each of them corresponding to degree 3 vertices on either side. So now the mapping can be easily defined in this way. Let us map the vertex U2 of the graph G to the vertex V3. So we write f of U2 equal to V3, and accordingly, as we specified earlier, let us define f of U4 equal to V5, f of U1 equal to V4, f of U3 equal to V6, f of U5 equal to V1, and f of U6 equal to V2. This function we have written accordingly with the adjacency of the vertices in graphs G and H. Now let us see whether this F is 1-to-1 and onto preserve adjacency or not. Clearly we can say that it is 1-to-1 and onto, satisfying the rules of 1-to-1 and onto. When we find the adjacency matrices of G and H, as the matrix is shown here, the two graphs having the same adjacency matrices. Because along with the three invariants of the isomorphism, when a function 1-to-1 and onto function is defined, preserving that the adjacency matrix of G always equal to the adjacency matrix of H, we are able to now conclude that the two given graphs are isomorphic. I hope you all understood the examples and the concept of isomorphism. Thank you one and all for your